You are reading a cool deep learning paper and want to dive into the very code that yield the results. Although full of motivation at first, you quickly feel out of your depth, lost in a mesh of interdependency and arcane algebra. In this video, I'll show my process for reading deep learning code using the SAM1 repo as a working example. For those that are new to the channel, I'm Yassine, a published researcher and machine learning practitioner who loves to teach. There are obvious reasons why you might want to read deep learning code if you are trying to use it in your own research. But for most practitioners studying deep learning, you get the following two main benefits. First, you obtain a deeper understanding of the method used and how they leverage various other sub-components you heard about. Looking behind the veil of the paper and seeing the code that made the result possible is what makes you go from knowing about the methods to understanding them. As you work through the notebooks and PyTorch models, you start to see more clearly how things are kind of glued together. Foreign concept becomes now nothing more than a few lines of PyTorch code slapped together. From experience, this exercise will have a major impact in your confidence in whatever area research you are evolving in. The second main benefit is that it gives you a new practical skill you can leverage for your own project later on. When you see how the cutting edge research is done, you gain a profound understanding for the craft of building deep learning models. This understanding applied to your own project will elevate your skill set beyond just mindlessly copy-pasting methods. You'll be able to gain an intuitive sense of what feels right and what could be tried out to achieve your goal. So let's get started. The very first prerequisite step is to read the paper thoughtfully to get all the contextual information. This might look obvious, but it has to be said. If you just read the blog or skim through the abstract, you'll miss critical context and implementation detail that stem from the codebase. Read the paper fully at least once and take notes of the various nomenclature used throughout. The next step is to try to make the code run using the provided documentation. Usually, deep learning code will have like enough information in the README so that you can properly run a model on some test data. It might not always be straightforward because of the complexity of research code. However, it's well worth it to get a top level sense of the input, output, how the system kind of manage these and what it requires to functions. Let's see how this looks like with SAM1. We're gonna check out this repository. As I said, I chose this one mainly because the code is clean. It's really clean and it's cutting edge. It's like, well, it was cutting edge in 2023, but now this has been superseded by segment editing 2. But still, the code is very clean and it's well thought of. So first thing first, we're gonna try to make this run. How we're gonna make it run is we can like install this whole stuff locally. I like to, if I'm just testing stuff out, just go into like Colab or like whatever other engine that is online and do the work of setting it up over there. So I don't have to mess around with a lot of stuff and the GPU and all this. So the first thing we're gonna do here is we're gonna install Segment Editing, the library that we just saw. Over there, you see that they added two things, the people.jpg, this image of me in a poster presentation. And then the parameters from this model, which is the segment editing model with the visual transformer, the H version. So this is just to showcase it. We're gonna store this into the image variable. Over there, we are gonna use the sum automatic mask generator. And here are our parameter that we need. It's just like how this code is set up to load it from the parameter. We put it over there, put this into a GPU, and over here we're creating the mask generator. At the end over here, we are using the image, and then it can generate the mask. Here, it's not too important, it's just to take the mask and then be able to showcase an image. And here we are with the segmentation. So this is, I believe it's taking like 100 points and it's trying to segment the stuff, and it's not doing too bad. So with this, we're able to, at a high level, just test out the input output and understand a bit how it's working. We're gonna take a deeper look over there at the SAM automatic mask generator afterward. Once you have successfully run the code, it's now time to map out the codebase structure at a high level. The quality of the codebase can really be felt in its overall architecture design. By mapping the architecture, you can get a better sense and appreciation of which area to focus on to truly understand the implementation. You'll also be able to get a better grasp at what type of researcher you're dealing with. If the architecture is kind of generally messy, you know you'll have to take whatever you find with a grain of salt and clean as you read. If the architecture is fairly clean, it usually means that things were properly trimmed down before the release. So let's check what they look like with SAM1. We Okay, so here we are for a high level overview of the infrastructure that we are dealing with. There's a bunch of stuff. If you know a bit programming and you've seen some codebase, you know where to look at stuff and where to just like disregard this whole thing. I don't care at all. And then I know like I have these folder that have some importance, right? This one, most likely there's nothing in it. It's just like assets to showcase in the README. And then there's these things that are of interest. Let's look at each one of them. The demo folder is actually just like a web app demo and React. So we don't have to do much here. After that, you have the notebook section, and this is useful to get a sense of like how to use these things. So in this case, they put like all of their kind of tutorial stuff in there. So to understand how to do the stuff that we've seen previously, I was looking mainly at automatic mass generator example in this notebook. Then you have the script folder, and in the script folder, it starts to be important. There's two files mainly. There's this thing, and then there's this thing over here. This one is more important than this. We just take a note of it, because when you look at the file, this is where a lot of the out of this stuff to build the segment editing model are stored. After that, you have the main folder, which is segment anything. And in this folder, you have a, kind of a typical machine learning project type of structure. You have stuff that goes into modeling over here. You have a utility library over here. You have what's called automatic mass generator over there, build SAM and predictor. We're gonna check each of these elements to understand a bit like how they are structured. So in the modeling folder, you have a bunch of files that correspond to all of the little building block that SAM is. So you have the image encoder that will be in there, the mass decoder code will be in there, the prompt encoder will be there. This should technically encompass all of these, right? And transformer should be inside over here. That should be the rough structure that we have. If you look back at the segment editing stuff, there's also the util folder structure. And then again, you have like AMG, ONNX, and you have this file that has like various transform that they're using. Careful here, we saw the same file twice. So we're gonna double check when we're gonna read the code if like we're talking about the util AMG or the script AMG. So at the high level, this is what's up. The most important part is really like everything that is in the segment anything folder. Overall, this is fairly clean. So this is also one of the reasons I took this repo for to showcase this process. Usually it's not like that. Usually it's a bit more messy, but then in this case it's a good one. Now that you have mapped out at a high level what's going on, it's time to elucidate each of the relevant elements by order of dependencies. Code in general, no matter where you're at, has quite a lot of abstraction layer and dependencies. Knowing how to navigate those is crucial. Deep learning code has the added difficulty of hiding a core concept between like subtle architectural design choice, which isn't obvious. Your knowledge from the paper will become very handy in spotting these regions and highlighting them for better understanding. To do so efficiently, I recommend starting from a top level component you work with and then finding a lower level nodes with low dependencies. These lower level nodes should be almost dependency free if possible, and you should understand what they do. Let's look at the SAM automatic mass generator for how this process looks like. We want to check out the SAM automatic mass generator thing. If you look back at our code, you see we have to import from segment editing the SAM automatic mass generator and the SAM model registry here. This thing is located over here. You see it in the init.py. We can see that we actually have it in the automatic mass generator file. So if we look at it here, this is where it's our entry point to the rest of the dependency tree for this code base, right? So if we land over here, then the exploration game, you have to see this really as a graph. The exploration game that you're doing at this point is you take the upper node where you actually interact with it to do something, in this case, like generating automatically a bunch of masks. And then you have to kind of explore, right? Kind of do a, let's say, depth first search to kind of find the nodes, right? And say like, oh, these ones, these are the nodes that like, they don't depend on anything. It will just tell me something. And then you go up the tree and you elucidate everything. The reason why you're doing it this way and not just trying to understand the top level first is like, look at this. There's all of these things that are being like abstracted away from you. If you have too much abstraction, when you're gonna read it, you're gonna feel it's magic, and you're not gonna understand it as much. So if we look in this, we have stealing stuff from modeling, from the predictor thing, from utils.amg. So it's not the script, it's the AMG one. And in this, there's a whole lot of stuff that we're taking, right? But these are the three main files that we are two main folder and files that we're taking our code from. So if we start with the modeling, we have Sam over here, right? And once you go into one of these files, you're gonna see this is like level two, but in level two, there's also other level. These dependencies, you have the image encoder, the mass decoder, and the prompt encoder. So all of these three come up into to build up SAM, just like in the paper. If we go a layer down, now we're three layer deep. We're in the modeling image encoder stuff, right? And we are doing still a bunch of importing. You see here we have from common, which usually common means like it's common from multiple file. Kind of a like sub library that you're putting your stuff here. We have normalization layer and MLP block that we jam over here. If we look at the mask decoder, then we still have from common, we're using the layer norm 2D again. And from the prompt encoder, it's same thing. We're still using the layer norm 2D. There's still other stuff we're using, but these is just, it's not that important. These are just libraries that are away. I would limit like the tree of dependency to only the stuff that are new from the researcher. Don't go and like look under the hood how Torch is doing their stuff. So here, common layer norm 2D. Now, so for layer deep, now we're like at the kind of at the lowest level, because if you take a look over here, oh, look at that. There's only the library stuff that we're importing and nothing else. So we hit one of our node. So if you read through this, right, and you understand what's going on, and you just take a note of it, and then you do the same thing here, and you take a note of it, what it effectively do is that now you're out of these things are magic and I don't understand what's up. Yeah, just take it as granted that they do work. And then you can bring this knowledge and this check mark to the layer above. So you bring it to the layer above over here. So it means that the prompt encoder, you have everything you need to understand it. Same thing for the mask decoder, you have everything you need to understand it. And for the image encoder. So these three, then you can go and then read them from top to bottom, understand what's up. And then you take another one, understand what's up, another one, understand what's up. You clear these up and then you can move a layer up again. So while moving a layer up, what you do, you go back to SAM and then you read it from top to bottom and you do a check mark on this. At this point, if you understood the image encoder, the mask decoder, and the prompt encoder, understanding this is just putting the stuff together. You don't have to, in your head, have all of the intricacy of the image encoder. You just know that it works and you understand the input output that we're using. And then you get out and in the SAM, you just take these for granted. Then we have the SAM predictor. SAM predictor, same thing. There's other stuff that are being used, but here we're importing the segment editing modeling. So SAM, we're importing this stuff. Resize longest side, shouldn't be too difficult, but like this is over there. So this is exactly what we saw before. So if you understood SAM in here, you will know what's up, right? You will know how it's used and how it's being leveraged. The only thing you have to double check is this one, which is in the utility AMG. And over here, you're gonna read it. You see, there's no dependency that is internal at this point. So all of these stuff are internal. So this is also a region where there's like lower level nodes that you need to get. Once you get that done, you move up a layer again, and then you finish the SAM predictor from top to bottom, you read it, and then you put a check mark. So you see, we kind of did like a first exploration, and then we cleared one node at a time, and then we continue our exploration. This is actually that first search. Finally, after all that, you will most likely hit conceptual knots that are unclear. Take note of them and work through them individually. One thing you have to understand at this point is that you're at the cutting edge. You're reading the literal implementation of a published paper that most likely only a handful of people on Earth understand at a deep level. Stuff might be weird, and some implementation detail might also be difficult to understand or slightly wrong. Don't beat yourself for it if it's hard. Take notes and study this point more deeply further. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like if it was the case, and leave a comment if you have any questions. I'm here to help. Have a great week, everyone, and see you in next video.